Hello, and welcome to the episode 67 of What A Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we will have six different live performances, the first color photo of the Quarrymen, and the remake of a solo single. On the 8th of March 1958, the Quarrymen performed at the wedding reception of Paul McCartney's cousin Ian Harris. Ian had asked Paul to bring some musician friends to provide musical entertainment, but only McCartney, John Lennon, and George Harrison were available to play. Of the Quarrymen, pianist Duff Lowe, T-chest bass player Len Gary, and drummer Colin Hanton were busy elsewhere and or didn't want to play for free. The result of the gig was the first known color picture of the trio. George had just turned 15 and had joined the band 1 week before. In the picture, he was sporting a sunburst Hofner President guitar, to which he had added a pickup to make it electric. Paul, instead, was seen with his famous Zenith Model 17 archtop guitar, his second instrument, a German import. A rosy-cheeked John stood behind the two with his first guitar, a Gallatin Champion. Also in the picture, on the right, a neighbor of Ian Harris called Dennis Littler, holding a pint, and, looking carefully on the left, a bit of the headstock of another guitar. It can't be said for sure, but it might have been Eric Griffiths, the Quarrymen's fourth guitarist in one of the final appearances with the group before he left. In December 2020, another photograph of the trio performing at the same wedding reception surfaced on the internet. There's no hint of Griffiths or any other guitarist in this second photo, so who knows, the fourth guitarist might have been one of the guests. In 1961, the same three lads, now with drummer Pete Best and performing as the Beatles, had three engagements in Liverpool in one day. A lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club, the second in the week. An early show at the Aintree Institute for a BK Promotions night, and a late evening appearance at the Hambleton Hall. Another live performance in 1962 with the Beatles, still featuring Pete Best on drums, performing at the Storyville Jazz Club. By the way, if you like this podcast, please visit www.simonmas.com/support to find ways to help me to make it even better. Thank you. On the 8th of March 1963, the Beatles played the Royal Hall in Harrogate, Yorkshire, the only concert in that town in their whole career. On this date, in 1965, the Fabs were still busy filming scenes for Help in New Providence, Bahamas, returning at a rundown hospital for handicapped children and elderly people for the temple scenes. Finally, in 1970, Ringo Starr started recording a remake of It Don't Come Easy, previously called You Gotta Pay Your Dues. The song, meant to be his first solo single in UK, had already been recorded on the 18th and 19th of February, but the only certain facts are that it didn't take place at the EMI studios and that George Harrison was involved as a producer and playing acoustic and electric guitar on the track. Like the previous version of the song, this recording featured Klaus Voormann on bass, Ringo on drums, Stephen Stills on piano, and Moll Evans on tambourine. George also provided guide vocals for the track. And with this, let's conclude this episode of What a Fab Day. Tomorrow we'll talk about the Beatles' second package tour. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.